Hey guys, what's up? It's Olivia and I am back again with another video. So today's video, I actually don't have any makeup on, so it's going to be a makeup video and I'm going to be doing like a drugstore makeup tutorial. But yeah, so that's what we're going to be doing today. All of these products are drugstore and some of them are actually brand new that I just bought yesterday. So some of them are going to be like my first impressions and stuff. So yeah, I'm going to show you those. And so I think that's it, so let's just get started with this video. Okay, so first I want to say that if I'm looking over that way, it's where my mirror is, so that's where I'm looking. So first we're going to start off with some primer. I got this yesterday, and it's the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Face. Loved you in a place where there was no space and time, yeah we came alive. I was souls intertwined. So that is the face primer. I don't know how I'm going to like say how I like this because I haven't used a face primer in general before. So I'm just going to say right now it feels very moisturizing to my face and everything. So that's just what I think of it right now. And then we're going to move on to foundation. This is the Fit Me Maybelline New York Fit Me Foundation in Matte and Poreless. In the shade 235. So I'm just gonna pour some of that on the back of my hand. So that is my foundation all blended in and stuff. It is a little bit lighter than me, like I said, because it is summer, so I've been tanning. So the next thing I'm going to move on to is I got this HD Lifting Concealer by e.l.f. So I thought I would just try this out. I think it's in the shade Light. So hopefully this is the right skin tone because I really wasn't sure. So it's this big and so I'm going to try it out. It is in the shade Light 83252. It's by e.l.f. So let's try it out. Another Monday night. I put this on and it kind of seemed kind of rough to put on, but at the same time, let's just blend it out and see how good it is. Okay. So that was the concealer and honestly, I really liked how it blended out and everything. It looks really good on my skin and everything, so I'm actually really happy with this product. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to set my whole face. So I'm going to use this e.l.f. finishing powder and this is in the shade Light Medium. So I actually have this and I've used a lot of it. So this is like my everyday powder and I'm using this tapered kabuki brush and so I'm just going to use that to really like put on all this powder. So yeah, that's my foundation all set, and now I'm going to move on to the eyebrows. So I've used this product for the longest time. I'm using the e.l.f. Brow Pencil, and so I actually really like this because it gives really good product out, and it's really good for its price, honestly, and I actually almost need a new one because I'm literally almost out. Okay, so now that I'm done filling in my eyebrows and everything, I'm going to use this brow gel and it's by Rimmel London Brow This Way. So I'm just going to use this to set my eyebrows. Okay, so now that my eyebrows are done, I'm going to move on to the face and then I'm going to do the eyeshadow. So I'm using this e.l.f. blush and bronzing powder. I've never tried this before, so we're just gonna see how it works. So it comes like this. This kind of reminds me of like NARS packaging, honestly. And I open it up and it has a mirror. So this is the blush and this is the bronzer. So I've actually I actually don't really use blush or bronzer, so I'm going to try this out. So I'm going to use the bronzer first. So in my opinion, I don't really like contouring, and I think this looks really bad. I'm pretty sure it's my fault, but like, the product is coming off really good though. So honestly, if you are a person who likes contouring and stuff, I think that you should get this because the product is really good and stuff. It's just, I think it's me because honestly, I just don't really like contouring and stuff because I already have pretty hollowed out cheeks. I don't know. We'll work with it, but honestly, I don't like it because I just don't, I personally don't like contour. Use this brush that I was just blending it out with. Make sure no products in there. And I'm going to get the blush color and I'm going to put blush on. I'm not a person to wear blush, but I think this is a really good blush. Just like, it's really subtle and stuff, and you can pack it on there if you like want a more blush, but honestly this is pretty subtle and so I kind of like it and stuff, so yeah, I like it. So next I'm actually gonna go into highlight. I got the Wet n Wild highlighting powder, and I've heard a lot of people talk about this and how good it is, so I'm hoping it is. I got it in Precious Petals, so I'm just going to open this up. So here it is, and then you just open it. And honestly, I really like how the imprint is. And I'm gonna use this like little small contour brush to actually put the highlight on. And I'm going to use this brush again, and I'm gonna use the Taper Kabuki brush and get it, because honestly, I think this is probably, oh God. I've heard a lot of great things about this, so I'm really hoping that it's really good. I really like this highlighter. I would definitely buy this again. So now moving on to eyes. I think this is one of the last things. So I bought this e.l.f. eyeshadow palette. It's a really small one. It's really simple, and I just like the colors in it. And it's called Golden Goddess. And yeah, so we're gonna open this up. So this is what it looks like. It, you open it up and it comes with 4 shades. I have the bronzing and blush palette thingy. And I'm going to use the bronzy color to kind of use it as a transition color. So that it's kind of like, yeah, just use it as a transition color. So now that I've done that, I think I'm going to grab, this color, and it's just the lid color. And I'm going to put that in the crease some more and blend it out a little bit farther than the transition color we used. So I'm going to move on to this more goldy bronzy color. The only thing I don't like about this is that it looks like it has like so much fallout. But then I'm gonna grab this more bristled one. It has like, it's more stiffer and stuff, and I'm gonna use it to really try to blend this color into my crease. I'm gonna grab this more concealer brush, and I'm gonna get the darkest one, and I'm barely gonna get it though. I'm really gonna tap off all the extra I can get, and I'm gonna put it just like barely in the crease just to give it more of a depth, you know. So I'm gonna do that, and I'm gonna blend it out with this little tiny contour brush again. Gonna grab that lid color again. It's more of a goldy color, and I'm gonna put that right in like the center of my eyelid. So then I'm going to get this flat concealer brush again, and I'm gonna get the base color on this, and I'm gonna use it as like an eyebrow highlight thing. Okay, so I actually really like how this turned out, and I would definitely recommend this to more beginners and everything, just to have more of a variety of things to use. And so I'm going to finish the other eye, and then I'll get back to you guys. Boop. get this really small, like, I don't even know what to call it, brush, and I'm going to get some of the highlight that we used earlier from Wet n Wild, and I'm actually going to put it in my inner corner to really brighten it up. So now after that, I'm actually going to still grab this brush, and I'm going to go back to the small little eyeshadow palette, and I'm going to get the darkest one, and I'm going to put this like right on the outer corner. And then after that, I'm going to grab the main color we used today, and I'm going to put that on the lash line too. Okay, so now I'm fully done with the eyeshadow. I'm going to move on to mascara. So first, I'm going to curl my eyelashes because I have very short and straight eyelashes. Normally, I don't really like using eyeliner, so that's why I'm not using it, because I just feel like it covers up the whole eyeshadow look that you've done. But if you do want to use an eyeliner, a really cheap and good eyeliner is actually by e.l.f. It's their liquid eyeliner, and this one is in jet black, so I would recommend this for you to use eyeliner and stuff. Mascara I'm going to be using is the Lash Sensational Curvititude by Maybelline New York, and so I'm going to use this to put on my mascara. So I'm done with my mascara. It's very subtle, very non-dramatic. You can put on falsies if you want to, but personally I just like to have my natural lashes, but maybe later in the years I will start using falsies and everything. And then lastly, I just use some chapstick because I don't really like wearing lipstick. That is my finished look. I really like how it turned out. I'm pretty happy with everything that I recently bought. I thought all of it worked really well and stuff, so a lot of this makeup I do enjoy and I'm probably going to use later in the future. So I like all of the makeup I bought, and so yeah. So that is the end of this video. I used all drugstore makeup products for this look, and I'm really happy with how it turned out and everything. And so yeah, that's the end of the video. I hope you guys liked it. If you did, then go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you aren't already subscribed to me, go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below. And my social medias are also down below if you want to go check those out. And yeah, so I will see you guys in my next video. Mm-hmm.